Alrighty guys, Neil Leonardo here, and I am going to just go and talk about habitable zones for as long as I possibly can. So hopefully I can get as much stuff in here as I can go. Now let's just get right into it, because the clock is ticking. So there's some new news about Alpha Centauri system, specifically Proxima B, who is a exoplanet orbiting Proxima Centauri, right? Proxima B orbits Proxima Centauri. Now, so basically, what's cool is that there, in this study, they have deduced that there is actually a decent chance that Proxima B will have liquid water and potentially life along with it. You know, that's always the hope. If you can find water on a habitable world, maybe you get some life also. Who knows? Now, as you can see, I've got Universe Sandbox Squared open just to give you guys something to look at and to help demonstrate what the heck I'm talking about. But anyways, let's actually turn the grid on, and basically you can see that this is, Alpha Centauri is obviously a triple star system, it says right there, on the side over here. And one note that I will make is that this is not the planet we are talking about right here. This would be Alpha Centauri BC, which is, and as you can see that there have been in two planets around Alpha Centauri B that have been discovered. As you can see right here, it says, in 2012, astronomers announced the discovery of an exoplanet Alpha Centauri BB orbiting one of the two binary stars. However, in 2015, further analysis revealed that this planet likely does not exist and was merely noise in the data. In 2013, another exoplanet, Alpha Centauri BC, was discovered orbiting the same star. And in 2016, astronomers announced the discovery of another exoplanet in the system, Proxima Centauri B, orbiting the distant red dwarf. So BC actually might exist then. I don't know though. I don't actually remember anything about BC being a thing. I'm pretty sure that it's only Proxima who is a confirmed exoplanet. Maybe BC is a candidate, but it's not actually, I don't know though. I can maybe go later into, I can maybe go into NASA's eyes and see what the heck we've got there in terms of, because that, I think, gets all of its data directly from the exoplanets catalog. So maybe we can venture in there some other time, probably not during this video though. So anyways, where's Proxima then? Proxima B is actually way the heck out here. As you can see its orbit there, it orbits at 600, a little under 6,685 AU, a lot of AUs. Where's one light year? That's one light year, just to show off. So it's like, that's one light year right there. And by the way, for any of you who do not know what an AU is, one AU is the distance between the Earth and the Sun. So that's a decent distance. I don't know why it cuts straight to kilometers here. But this is the barycenter, basically where between all three of these stars, where the center of their gravity is. Right? So they're essentially all orbiting around the barycenter, except Proxima, for some reason, is not orbiting in this. Like, if I actually just hit play, you can actually see that this is moving. We're looking straight at Alpha Centauri. Yeah, and it looks like the path, yeah, it's going straight away from that for some reason. If we actually just speed this up just a bit, you can see that it's making a healthy clip away from them, and so I don't know why that is. I think that that's some problem with the simulation, because it should be orbiting. It just started like that. I've reset it multiple times to try and make it orbit. But anyways, we're not here to talk about the flaws in Universe Sandbox. So let's just go back down. So welcome to Proxima B, the nearest exoplanet to Earth, basically. And so, as you can see, is this water? I can't tell whether that's water or ice. I think it's water. But anyways, Proxima B is supposed to be a planet that, an exoplanet that is potentially habitable. Whoa, it just got really red all of a sudden. But there's been a lot of debate among scientists of whether it is habitable. And so, a lot of the arguments for against it being habitable has been, well, obviously there's still a lot of unknowns here, but some of the basic arguments against it is that M dwarfs, like Proxima Centauri is definitely very active in its solar flares, and many M dwarfs are very active in their solar flares. And that's not very good for having a very nice, stable atmosphere. Mainly just because it's like, it's a very strong solar wind, and it will push slowly, like, degrade the atmosphere. And then once the atmosphere is gone, obviously the water's just left in a very low pressures and low vacuums, right? So something similar like this happened to Mars, where it didn't have enough mass to hold its atmosphere, and thus all of its water either froze or evaporated. So, because it lost a lot of heat as well, as atmospheres usually help retain heat. So atmospheres are a very crucial part to how we think of the habitable zone of a star. Because obviously, if you've got a thicker atmosphere with a lot of greenhouse gases like Venus, you want that thing incredibly far away. And in fact, I've run simulations in Universe Sandbox Squared with Venus, and you would, with Venus's current atmosphere, you would want it all the way out to where Jupiter is to have it be stable. Now, of course, a lot of that carbon dioxide would probably just fall back down. Okay, I'm gonna keep talking longer. 10 minutes, it's just way too short. A lot of the carbon dioxide might fall back down, then reducing the greenhouse gas, and then the reducing of the greenhouse gas might actually make it so it actually needs to be a little bit closer in than Jupiter, because all of a sudden all that CO2 is probably like in the ground instead of all up in the air. So basically, yeah. So Proxima B, why does it keep changing color? I think it has a slightly elliptical orbit. I don't know how accurate this is. Obviously, there's a few inaccuracies within this simulation. So this is not 100%. And they don't have the most recent data always when we're running these simulations. So keep that in mind here. What's a good stopping point? 20 minutes. I'll do try to stop around 20 minutes again. But anyways, so basically what we have, the study about Proxima is one where we basically ran a very accurate Earth simulation. What's the program called? Rock 3D, I think it is. 3D simulations using resolving climate keys of Earth and extraterrestrial modeling software, and a potentially habitable ancient Venus. Okay, so yeah, basically they're able to model, you know, planets and the factors that go into planets and stuff like that. I'll leave a link in the description to this below. I'm trying not to stay on this too much, but basically they've learned that there's a few things to really take away from that article though, and that's that the water cycles of Proxima B will have, if it's any warm enough to have any water at all, they'll actually have water cycles to, because this is tidally locked most likely. They also talk about a two-thirds resonance with the star, which allows a very slow spin. Basically, something, you know, two-thirds resonance is something resonant with how quickly it orbits the star, right? A day equates to about how much, to some amount of time that it orbits the sun. Mercury has it, apparently, as the paper, or maybe the paper doesn't state that. No, it's talking about a two-thirds resonance. I think I got that from somewhere else. Yeah, I think that was from Anton Petros. Be careful with him, by the way. I've noticed that he occasionally has a few flaws, but I mean, my videos will probably have flaws too. We're only human after all. Is there a freezing and thawing cycle? What's the temperature right here right now? Density, surface temperature is -5. Oh geez, it's going down. Or is it going up? Okay, I see. Those are the seasons. Okay, yeah, I guess that in this simulation it's elliptical enough that the seasons affect whether it's frozen or thawed. The study that paper gives is really good news for Proxima. Means that it's potentially more habitable than we used to thought. We used to think that it's like, oh, tidally locked. It's like all the hot side's gonna be exposed with heat and a bunch of radiation, allowing all the atmosphere to go away and then evaporating all the water. And so it's probably not habitable for life. It's probably just a barren rock like Mars. But no, this is good news that water and atmosphere both might stick around, especially with two-thirds resonancy any orbit at all will really help circulate the temperature a little bit, just so that the night side will actually get some heat too. But even if it's tidally locked, the atmosphere, or granted, it'll still be frozen, but it would probably, and I think that in the study they actually say if there's enough salt, and any, and some basic science will tell you that salt in salt water has a lower temperature than just fresh water. So if there's enough salt in the oceans, the night side could actually be liquid too, even if it's tidally locked. I don't know if it's tidally locked in this simulation. It looks like, yeah, no, that doesn't look like tidally locked. It looks like it's got no orbit at all, I don't think. And as I stated before, circulating currents in water and also thick atmospheres will just allow enough heat to get transferred into the night side where there's not enough. You know, if you, it would move some of the heat that gets put on the day side into the night side. Because, you know, hot things tend to go away from the heat source. As seen, it's like, as with, you know, I can't even words right now. Anyways, let's not stick on that too long. I'm running out of time. Yeah, well, that's probably enough about habitability for now. I'm really tired, and this has been dragging on for far too long. I am going to have such a hard time trying to edit this, but anyways, and I think I even had to cut out a few more things to talk about habitable worlds. Habitable. I feel like I'm pronouncing that wrong. It's late. I don't care. It's time for me to start thinking about going to bed. Well, it was great talking to you all. I hope that you all did enjoy, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. See ya.